channel, and today we'll be going into Shader Editor. And if you don't have it up currently, then you can just open this tab on the side and it will come up. It's also on Shift F3, but on your computer it may be different, but it will say on the right hand side. Now here we have the principal PSDF and the material output, and we'll be adding a few things in. So make sure you like and subscribe to all my videos so that you can stay tuned. Before we start this video, thank you to Pendo, and big shout out to him. So for all of you who are looking for a channel, make sure to follow his. So today in Blender we will be creating and trying out a few different objects. So if we shift A like the usual, we can add an input. I'll just show you a quick one. Let's do shift add. If we do an input, we can have a bevel. And now this bevel, you can see here there's a pipple and it says normal. So if we attach that to the normal hair, then we can add different samples and radiuses. Can't currently see it, but if we go into here, we can see it more. If we shift A, we can do an output, a material output, which is what we've got here. A shader, we can do the there's a principal BSDF. Any one we can create, it goes into a material output, which is where we can add different things into. But I'm not going to go into much like that, and I won't be doing or adding these in this video. But there will be a lot of stuff on this, so make sure to subscribe so that you do not miss out. And to get rid of that, if we do shift A, we can add a texture. We can do any of these. I'm just quickly going to grab an environment texture and we can add that into the color. You can see here you can add or open a image. If you don't have an image, then well, it won't work as well. So we can add any image in there, and I'm going to quickly grab one for a second to show you what it will look like. So I've just got an image here, and we can see up here what it looks like. It's sort of a circle around. This is the blue cotton that I've added, but if I get rid of this, this is called an environment texture. So if we just open that again, or another one, you can see it's all circles and very similar. If we add a cylinder and then we add a material, or we just add the previous one, then we'll have what we had before. This looks like some sort of rolled rug, and it can easily be put into images or objects. We can also do mesh around it, so it actually looks, or it actually is like this, but I'm not going to do that because we're doing shading editor. If I shift add another texture, let's do a magic texture. Let's just delete that. If we add this magic texture to the color, you can see that it's got different colors. This looks pretty cool. If you want to change the depth, you can see they sort of change the color. And it sort of gets deeper and deeper every time. That's why it's called depth. If we go back to about 3, we can see the colors. We can see the colors more large. If we go to 0, we've got this sort of pattern along the top. Now I'm going to show you another one. If we shift add, then we can add another texture. Let's go for a brick. If we put the color into the base color, then we can see there are bricks all along this. And they're different types, so you can change the colours if you want to. And I'll show you a quick thing for that. If we shift add, we can go on to colour, and we can add a mix RGB. Mix RGB is where they'll mix the two colours you've put in. So if I go for a blue, they've sort of mixed the two colours together to make this cool brick look. If I just add another colour RGB, then we can add this onto colour 2 and then change the colours here. Let's go for a green and a red or pink. Then we can see we've got the colours here. This won't be so great for a wall or something like that on this side, because you can see they're all very stretched. But if we go into UV editing, we can change that so that they will look correct. And there's a video for that, in fact, if you would like to go on it. So make sure you subscribe to watch that too. If we get rid of this mix RGB and add in, let's do a light fade off and just line a few of these up, you can see there are a few different changes here which you may enjoy or not. There's different joins that you can connect, and you can see that they change each time. If we add this, there's sort of a curve in the colours. And then if we put the colour into, let's say, colour 2, you can see that this has got a curved sort of colour. It looks really cool how the black is there. So if you are thinking, oh, I prefer that to be white or something like that, you can change it all around if you don't like the colour. I'm just going to shift add a hue slash saturation. You can, if you just hover over a line with these, you can connect them. So there, it's brought some light and saturation to this. If we add, we can add brightness, contrast, and all these different things. So make sure to test and try out and see if you can get anything you quite enjoy. The next thing is vector. If we add let's do a bump and just add it onto here. But let's do into vector and put it away from the colour. So you see I have accidentally put it over and it hasn't done it correctly. But you can undo that easily. And you can see now it's all blue and slight bits on the side, but not at the top. That's because this bump does it. If we get rid of that, then they're back to normal. If we add, let's do a combined, we can add different colours. So we'll go into colour 1 here, and you can change these different colours. You see we've got a grey here, so this combined colour has sort of made a grey, and so is this one. So if we just zoom out a bit, it looks very cool. You can see we've got a line here, but that's just part of the bricks that they've added on. There's script, which it's not amazing, but you can just exit and import the script to different areas. If we shift add, we can make groups and make layouts. So if we do a reroute, we can put that there and then just join that up here, then join that here. So we can see that line clearly, and instead of it going everywhere. So if you have tons of lines joining up to something, you can just create one like that. Also, if we move this back, this dot over here connects to a lot of things, but can only connect one thing to that thing. So if we undo that there, join the colours up, shift add, we can add a frame. this is where you can't actually join things up, but it's a sort of frame for different things. So test your understanding on that and try out a few different other objects. And I hope you enjoyed this quick video, because I certainly have enjoyed recording all of these. Make sure to like and subscribe, please, guys, and there will be a huge shout out for those who do, and comment down below done when you are. And thank you for all the comments you've given me. It's really helpful, and I've loved and enjoyed this. So please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.